Hi drummers, hope you're well. So in response to lots of viewers and channel members asking for more bass drum play-alongs, here's a great one for you. This is a little play-along based on page 11 of Time Functioning Patterns by Gary Chaffee. Absolutely solid gold resource, this book, and absolutely love it. One of the best books in this little series of pages. For me, pretty much the ultimate sort of bass drum workout. I'm going to play from page 11 here, the first half of it, just numbers 1 to 15. We're going to play along to Ariana Grande positions, and we're going to play 8th notes on the hi-hat for the first run-through. We're going to play 16th notes on the hi-hat with one stick for the second run-through, and we're going to play 16th notes with two sticks on the hi-hat, as in right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, if you're right-handed, on the third run-through. And just follow me, and I'll shout out the numbers as we go. I'm assuming here, of course, that you know this book and have some familiarity with this. For example, you're a channel member and you've got your practice plan and you're working on this, or you already own this book and you're into it. If you need more descriptions about what this is all about, how this drill works and building it up, I've got several other videos I've made about that, and I'll link to those below. Please check that out first. But on this one, we're just going to get into it. Here we go, man. Follow me. And so I'll just shout out the numbers as we go. So 8th notes on the hi-hat, pattern number 1.
Said you to me. I'm just hoping I don't repeat history.
Number 3.
Boy, I'm trying to read your mind on Sunday. The nigga like love on Monday.
Number 4.
Never need no one else, babe. Cause I'll be
number
switching
five.
Up the positions for you.
As you get the hang of this, like I'm doing there, you can throw in perhaps a little drum fill of some sort from one to the next, just to punctuate it and keep it interesting. Okay, next one, 16th notes on the hi-hat. All with one stick. One, two, pat, one.
Said you to me. I'm just hoping I don't beat history. I'm trying to meet your mama on Sunday. The nigga like love on Monday. Never need no one else, babe. Cause I'll be
switching
up positions for you.
Number 6.
Perfect, perfect. too good to be true. But I get tired of running. Fuck it, now I'm running with you. With you. So I'm trying to meet mama on Sunday. The nail I left on Monday. Don't even honest, babe. Cause I'll be switching up positions.
Sticks on the hi-hat. I'll try and hold on to my sticks.
Be true. But I get tired of running. Fuck it.
man. Love it. So it's just the sort of thing I like to do in practice. I would often run like in a face-to-face session, especially when we've got the two kits, you know, side by side to run along. I think that's great because you're working on bass drum technique and coordination in a big way as well. And I'm going to say that thing I always say, like, it obviously depends where you're at with your drumming, but I would say this builds bass drum skills from grade 3 upwards is all I'm going to say. So obviously this goes on forever and there's no, like, this is this whole series of different patterns. It's not one particular grade level, but it, I would say it starts from grade 3. The idea of, like, in the first four example here, putting one bass drum in like the four possible positions in a group of 16ths, you know what I mean, on the one, on the E, on the and, on the and then you do the same thing with kick, with two kicks and then three kicks and finally four kicks. So that's great. Hope that you'll find that useful. I was clearly practicing myself there. I dropped the stick twice, I think. So there you go. I keep it. I like to keep it real on this channel. I just play that in real time. And sometimes that's it. I play it and I'll put it up for you. Hopefully that's useful. Have a little play along with it. Let me know how you find it. Like I say, please bear in mind that, you know, because sometimes I get comments back and it's apparent that people are, you know, trying to do material like this often when they haven't been playing the drums really that long at all, and that's cool. Obviously, I massively admire the ambition. This is a grade 3 upwards thing, I would say, just to be super clear about that. So you'd expect drummers to be, you know, have been playing and practicing regularly for, you know, at least a year or two, I'd say, before you get into a drill of this nature. Clearly, I could do some work on this, so I'm going to go and practice that again. Have fun. Any questions about that, give us a shout. And thanks, as always, for watching. Really appreciate it. Please like, share us, and subscribe. And thanks a million to all the amazing people who support this channel via my Buy Me a Coffee support page. Hugely appreciate that. Lots of people are buying me a coffee in the last week or so. I'll do some shout-outs very soon. Buy Me a Coffee is buying someone a coffee in that sense is a single one-off show of support for this channel if you found it useful or helpful or enjoyed it in some way. And the other option via that same page is to become a channel member. As a channel member, for £10 a month, you're becoming part of this channel, helping it grow and supporting it, and you get a whole lot of stuff in return, including a complimentary practice plan, ongoing drum support from me, members' videos, breakdowns of the video, like note for note covers, or the not note for note covers that I put up on here, a whole load of other features as well, including access to future Zoom sessions. I want a complimentary Zoom session or face-to-face session in the first place if you want one, plus loads of other features planned on that front, so feel free to check that one out. Details in the description below. Thanks a million. Good luck with your bass drum drills. See you soon. Cheers.